Hi, my name is Patrick, and today we'll learn about how to create a reading progress indicator like the one that you're seeing here at the top of this page, but without JavaScript. As you can see, if I scroll down and up, it grows or shrinks according to my progression through the article, and it eventually fills up the entire width of the page when I'm at the bottom of the article. If you want to do this today, it requires a bit of JavaScript. It's not really hard, but it does require you to listen to the scroll event, which is not ideal in terms of performance. And if any of your JavaScript breaks, then that part would break as well. CSS has a really cool new feature called Scroll Animation Timeline, which has two things. One, a new property called Animation Timeline, which allows you to use an animation and make it run according to the scroll position instead of time. And then second, an add rule called scroll timeline, which allows you to define what this scroll behavior is going to be. So using this new feature, you can make your animations respond to the scroll position purely with CSS without having to use any JavaScript and let the browser do all of the heavy lifting, make it performant and all of that good stuff. The only downside is that it's still experimental. It's a new API that's about to be released very, very soon. But for now, if you want to try it, you're going to have to use either Edge or Chrome or Firefox, as all of those browsers have it behind a flag at the moment. But it's a really cool new feature that unlocks a lot of other effects that today are really hard to do on the web, like this parallax effect, for example. So let's dive in. First of all, let's enable the feature. I'm using Microsoft Edge here, so I'm going to go to the About Flags special page and look for the Experimental Web Platform Features flag. Make sure that it's enabled. In my case, it's already enabled, but in your case, if it's not, you're going to have to restart the browser. If you want to follow along using Firefox, you can go to the About Config page and then set the layout.css.scrollLinkedAnimations.enabled flag to true. Scroll timeline animations work just like other CSS animations. So let's get started by creating an element in our page, which will give an idea of progress bar. It's just going to be a div with a fixed positioning so that we can put it in the top left corner of the page and it just stays there. And we'll give it some height and a color, but no width, so that the element is not visible at first, and we'll let the animation make it grow all the way to the full width of the page. Next step, we'll animate the element. Let's create a different rule for the same element where we will create the CSS animation just like we do for any normal time-driven animation. As you see, we even use the 1 second time here in that case. And then we will create the add keyframes rule to define the animation from a width 0 to a width 100%. Now we'll wrap this entire piece of code in an add supports rule so that the browsers that don't support the animation timeline property yet will not animate this element at all. And now we'll use the feature to turn this time-driven animation into a scroll-linked animation. The first thing that we need to do here is to use the new animation timeline property to tell the engine which timeline this animation will use. In fact, if we set this to auto, which is the default value, then the animation will continue to be driven by time. But in our case, we're specifying a custom timeline here. And now second step is to actually define this timeline. So we'll use the new add scroll timeline rule here, which needs three things. First, the source, which we'll set to auto to mean that the animation should be linked to the scroll bar of the main document, but that could also be used to target any given nested scrollable container. Then orientation vertical to say that we want to respond to the vertical scroll and not your horizontal scroll instead. And finally, we'll define the scroll offsets from 0% to 100% to cover the entire scrollable surface of the document. That's it. We've got our animation working now. The feature can be used to do much more complicated effects than the one that I've demoed here. This was a simple demonstration of the feature. In particular, the scroll offsets property is very, very flexible. I showed the parallax effect in the introduction. It's a great example of what can be done. It was done by Bramus, who also created this other excellent demo that you're seeing now. And I hope that this gives you an idea of what's possible to do with the feature. If you're interested and you want to play with it, check out the links in the description for more information and links to the source code. That's it for today. I hope this was useful. Thanks for watching.